아아 마이크 테스트. 안녕하세요. 다시 만났네요. 얼마 전에 그림 시연회를 하고 있었는데요.
Because I'm colorblind. All I can see is gray tone.
Bob, 어떤 남자가 저한테
I
오더니, 저는 생명이기 때문에 그림을 그려본 적이 없습니다. 저는 오직 회색만 볼수 있거든요. 그래서 오늘은 누구나 그림을 그릴 수 있다는 걸 보여주기 위해서 회색으로만 그림을 그릴 겁니다.
Okay, gent. All right, here we are, ready to go again.
안녕하세요.
Just recently, I was doing a demonstration in a mall, and I had a man come to me, and he said, "Bob, I can never paint because I'm colorblind. All I can see is gray tones." So I thought today we'd do a picture in gray just to show you that anyone can paint. So, what I've done here, I've mixed up a gray... thought today we'd do a picture in gray just to show you that anyone can paint. So, what I've done here, I've mixed up a great batch of blue and brown.
갈색과 파란색을 섞어서 회색을 만들어 놨어요.
The mixture is here. And all we'll use is this gray color.
이 회색과 흰색만을 오늘 사용할 겁니다. 다른 색들도 팔레트에 남아 있는데 그것은 제가 게을러서 팔레트를 씻어 놓지 않았기 때문이죠. 일단 캔버스에 먼저 매직 화이트를 미리 칠해 놨고요. 붓을 회색에 붓을 두드려 주세요. 이쪽에 하늘을 칠해 줄 거예요. 계속해서 붓을 둥근 패턴으로 움직여 주세요. 아마 이쪽에도 그려주면 좋겠죠. 이쪽에 광원이 있을 거예요. 이쪽에서 빛이 들어올 것 같아요. 우리 지난 몇 주 동안 산을 그리지 않았죠? 오늘은 산을 그릴 시간이 된 것 같아요. 자, 이제 붓을 씻고 여분의 시너를 털어낸 다음에
gentle swirling motions here. We're going to begin blending the sky together.
하늘을 섞어줄 거예요. 아주 조심스럽게.
These little things just fall around, fly around, have fun.
이렇게 당겨주세요. 빛이 이 방향으로 비친 걸 표현해 주는 거예요. 자, 이쪽도 붓을 끊임없이 둥글게 움직여 주세요. 제가 드릴 수 있는 제 가장 중요한 팁이에요. 그렇지 않으면 이걸 하지 않으면 마치 비가 오는 것처럼 보일 거예요. 그렇게 그리기 싫거든요. 조심스럽게 색을 섞어주고
Now, take the fan brush, and I'm going to take a little bit of this gray color on the fan brush.
펜붓에 회색을 아주 조금만 묻혀서.
And let's put a few little happy clouds in here that are a little bit more distinct. And that'll push everything else.
작은 구름을 좀 더 두드러지게 그려줍시다. 똑같이 원형 패턴으로.
Just let these little clouds float around the sky.
구름들이 하늘에 펼쳐져 있을 거예요.
Now we'll take the big brush.
그리고 큰 붓을 이용해서 구름의 뒷부분을 조금씩 섞어 줍시다. 그리고 회색을 좀 더 추가해서 이쪽에도 구름을 그려주는 것이다. 마찬가지로 큰 붓으로 섞어주고요. 네, 이렇게 멋진 하늘이 끝났습니다. 자, 이제 멋진 산을 그려볼까요? 모두가 산을 좋아하죠? 똑같은 회색을 이용해서 네. 멋진 산을 그려줍시다. 남아있는 페인트를 아주 힘을 줘서 눌러준 다음에 큰 붓을 이용해서 이제 티타늄 화이트를 이용해서 산의 하이라이트를 그려줄 거예요. 아마 이쯤 될 것 같네요. 아마 이쪽에 태양빛이 닿을 거예요. 이제 회색과 흰색을 섞어서 약간 하이라이트보다는 진하지만 이 가장 진한 검은색보다는 옅은 회색을 이용해서 그림자를 표현해 줄 겁니다. 이쪽에도 이렇게 이걸 할 때는 아주 끈적한 페인트를 이용해야 돼요. 그렇지 않으면은 마치 진흙을 섞는 듯한 그런 실수를 하게 될 거예요. 이쪽에도 이 봉우리를 돋보이게 하는 그림자를 그려주면 좋겠죠. 상상력을 동원해서 이 각도를 따라서 브러쉬를 두드려준 다음에 다른 쪽에도 산을 연습해 보면 좋을 것 같네요. 아, 멋진 산이에요. 이렇게 이 산은 좀 더 진하게 했어요. 왜냐면은 좀더가까운산으로표현하고싶었기때문이죠그래서색깔을좀더진하게사용했어요브러쉬를씻고스튜디오를사야지이거온자이제산에눈을그려줍시다멋지지않아요단몇분만에산을그릴수가있죠큰비법이있는게아니랍니다그냥가슴으로상상만하면돼요그리고멋진나이프만있으면되죠그림자를표현해줍시다여기쯤이겠네요여기에산에입체감을주는거이거참쉽죠다각도만잘찾으면돼요산은기하학적으로생겼으니까요각도를잘활용하세요아주조심스럽게산밑부분을섞어줍시다그리고이쪽에물이있을거예요스튜디오에신세를많이지고있죠1인치컷을이용해서
exist anywhere.
And maybe.
Maybe, maybe. Maybe there's some little evergreens back here. Maybe we'll make some with a fan brushing. And maybe we'll make some with a palette knife today. That's a little bit different. Alright, let's drop a little evergreen right here. And I'm using a color that's very, very close to the background mountains. So they look far, far away. We can get the trees get longer too. As you make trees that in your mind are a little bit closer to you, allow them to get a little darker. A little bit darker.
가까이 있는 걸 표현을 하면은 좀 더 진하게 그려주면 돼요.
He's closer, so we want him darker.
이 나무는 좀 더 가까우니까 진하게 보일 거예요.
Since this is a wet-on-wet technique, you can smooth the paint. It'll slide. The magic white underneath makes it wet and slick. And it'll just slide and move. All you have to do is learn to control it a little. Okay. Now, let's take, put a little bit of reflection into the water.
물에 반사면을 표현해 줍시다.
Color, and I'm just going to gently pull down. Straight down. Most important that it comes straight down. Maybe we'll make an uneven
아래쪽 방향으로 똑바로 당겨주세요.
If you pull it down, very gently go across. Just enough to give it a watery feel. It's easy to destroy. Look at that already. Let's take a little bit of the magic white. Mixed with a little bit of firm white. I want to paint this a little bit thinner. There we go. Cut through it. And let's put some happy little water lines back here.
물의 경계선을 매직 화이트로 표현을 해줍시다.
Now, watch right here. And we'll create a little cove.
여기를
just that easy.
참 쉽죠.
But all these lines need to be basically straight, or once again, your water will run right out of the painting. Just letting it run right on around the corner here. Just like so. Okay. Let's make some happy little evergreen trees. And promised today we'd make them a little bit different than we have in the past. We'll make them with the almighty palette knife here. You'll decide basically where you want a tree, right there. Now, we're going to take, load just a tiny bit of paint right on the point of the knife and touch. And we just begin touching. We're not trying to draw with this knife. All we're doing is laying paint on the canvas. We touch the canvas takes what it wants, gives you back what's left. Just let this tree work right out of your mouth. We're still using nothing but the blue and the Van Dyke ground. Passion blue, Van Dyke. There's a little tree. Maybe right there is another one. I just want to do enough of these to show you how to do it. And when you do your painting at home, you determine how many trees live in your forest. There we go. See there? A lot of paint though. And what's really nice, when this painting dries, these trees are very thick. You can feel the texture. Maybe over here, maybe a great big tree, maybe one that, maybe he's tired. Like that. But once you do that, you're committed. You've got to put a tree there now.
페인트를 많이 묻혀서 아주 많은 페인트를 이용하세요. 그리고 줄기를 라이프를 이용해서 줄기를 긁어주세요. 코어 작은 줄기들이 여기저기 있을 거예요.
We need a shadow side and a highlight side, so I'll just use the same basic shadow colors I used on the mountain. Maybe a little touch darker. There we go. All right, very gently, very gently. Just touch so the paint grabs on those high points.
아주 조심스럽게. 그림자를 넣어주세요. 그림자가 먼저예요. 화이트로
and very gently once again.
아주 조심스럽게
don't want to kill all that beautiful dark color.
멋진 어두운 색을 죽이고 싶진 않아요.
Little tiny bit. This dark paint going here. Let's just lay a little bit right under here. Okay. There. Now we'll take a 1-inch brush. Back to one of our golden rules. It takes dark in order to show light. So we'll take a take a 1-inch brush back to one of our golden rules it takes dark in order to show light so we'll take a dark color on the 1-inch brush here we'll throw in some little bushes these are just the shadows for the bushes Always try to remember to do the thing that's farthest away first. In my mind, this tree's behind these bushes, so you need to do him first. And then come forward. And now that we have dark, we can begin worrying about the light. Let's pull this down right here and turn into a happy little reflection. Zip. Okay. Now we use a 1-inch brush with a little magic white and a little firm white mixed together. We're looking for a paint that's slightly thinner than what's on the canvas already, so it'll stick.
And at the same time, you can reflect them right into the water. 마찬가지로 물에 반사된 모습도 표현해 줍시다.
Don't want to destroy. Just want to diffuse a little. That's how we make mirror reflections.
그래서 면을 흐트러주고요.
Let's take a little bit of the white and put some snow down here on the ground.
흰색을 이용해서
thin white, and we'll make a little water line underneath it. All right. Okay, now we can take and just cut a few little sticks here and there. Just like so. Okay, now we got to worry about the other side. That one's looking good. A little more of the thin white mixed with a thicker white, so it'll stick.
이쪽에도
and we'll put some happy little bushes right along here.
Okay, 흰색 이파리새를 그려줍시다.
This is a cold painting. Blue and it makes it so cold.
차가운 그림이에요.
Okay, we'll put a few little stems in these.
진리 옆에.
You know, this reminds me of my home in Alaska. We see a lot of scenes like this. I've always wanted to live in a beautiful mountain range like this. So let's build a house.
집을 지어줍시다.
We'll make the back eave of the house first. Just like so.
먼저
we'll make the other side of the house.
Oh, shit.
It's just white. Let it run right down the canvas. White get on your knife, just to give it a little tonal values in there. That side should be good and dark. Let's give him a door. He needs a door. There we go. Little touch of the magic white to outline it. Maybe this is an old slab cabin, so we'll put some boards in here. And we need some snow on the other side of the roof.
그리고 반대편에 눈, 쌓인 눈을 표현해주고
snow on it. We need snow on both sides.
눈은 양쪽에 모두 쌓이니까요.
Some snow on the ground.
그리고 이제 바닥에도 눈이 쌓였겠죠?
And snow is a game of angles like mountains are. It's most important that you follow the lay of the land when you're laying the snow in. Just let it go in the direction the land flows. Let's push this little house back up into the bushes a little more. I'll take a little bit dark.
집 뒤에 덤보를 좀 그려줄까요?
And then some of the light color. And just throw some highlights on the bush. Like so. And maybe a little bush lives right there. maybe? Just to play a little there. Let's throw a little tree right through here.
이쪽에 참 나무가 있을 것 같아요.
I'm going to use the liner brush and some thin oil, and I'll thin some of this down a little. Put some happy little limbs out here on this tree. Just let them run along. Wherever you think they ought to be. And you can use paint thinner to thin this paint down. I prefer oil because it's slicker. It moves.
페인트 시너를 이용해도 돼요.
There we go. Maybe one more. Right there.
이쪽에도 하나.
Just let me go. A few little sticks down here at the bottom.
밑에 가지들을 좀 표현해 줄까요?
A little bit of oil here, and we're going to sign him in red.
이제 오일을 이용해서 이쪽에 사인을 해줄 거예요.
This is a fantastic painting because it uses
only gray and white.
I'd like to show you a variation.
회색과 흰색만을 이용하는 환상적인 그림이죠.
And it uses only burnt umber and white. So maybe we can get the camera to swing over to that, and we'll take a look at it. And show you what you can do with other colors. And there's really no limit to what color.
어떤 색깔이든.
Any color will work as long as you use the basic method.
기본적인 방법을 이용하면 한다면은.
On behalf of all of us here, you have a super day. Any color will work as long as you... use the basic.
애니메이션.